pocket. I want to close your hands because whatever you type, it goes through your fingers. It slips in your hand. And then now you are worried because you're looking at your age. You're like, you know, everything that happens. Mama, forgive those women. Okay? Not allow me to say, not all of us are married to families that everybody's going to be. I once said to somebody, you are not married to a family for them to love you. You are married to them for their son to love you. Whether we love you or we hate you is none of your business. Your own is the one you came for. Isn't it? Because we women, we lose our peace, we lose our homes, we lose, because I'm so stuck on my sister-in-law doesn't like me, my brother-in-law hates me, my mother-in-law. As long as the one who brought you still loves you. Not that I will hate you. I won't hate you. I will still cook for you. Huh? Best, nice meals. I will still clean for you. I will still watch for you. My only concern is the one who brought me, as long as he's still able to say, I love you. Mm-hmm. I don't have to hate for you.
Amen.
For
you.
So please forgive. Okay? Please forgive. And keep on doing. You hear what he said today? You keep loving, you keep humbling yourself. God is the one who will fight. Right? Mommy, please, your hand on your chest. Jesus. Out! Out! Jesus' name. I want this business to be. Jesus, Jesus. 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 I'm out. I'm out. Jesus. I want little people to come to feed you tonight. You when they come to run away. Did your wife go to the doctor and they said something like cyst? That has to do with the ovaries.
I'm not sure.
If you go to the doctor, they will say you have a cyst.
Yeah? In 2011, they removed it. And never right. So, lately, I'm going to be like, I'm going to be like,
put your hands there.
In Jesus' name. Jesus.
You are free. You're not married. You, your family, the spirit of Mary, the next this one, they live, we find another. You leave that one, you marry another one. Like that. It's how people in your family, everybody in your family has been working.
Yes.
How people live in your family. Your family doesn't really differ much from my family. So I want to pray for you so that you marry. God help you restore that. That your age is not, so that you break from this kind of things. If you can marry, your things will go well. But marry a Christian. Okay? Yeah, I know people these days if they're trying. They say if you marry a person who drinks alcohol, you will never have a problem. And they are. It's what they're saying. If you marry a person who drinks alcohol, you never have a problem, because whenever they want to groove, you let them groove. It's a lie. You can't be at your age, you are asleep at 12 o'clock, and me, I'm your wife, I am groovy. Will you sleep? I'm a Christian. I had him. God will give you money, my brother, but don't forget God.
Amen.
Okay? You have a spiritual husband. Do you see this person who comes at night to come and sleep with you?
Yes.
You dream somebody coming at night to come and sleep with you?
Yes.
That's what I'm referring to as a spiritual husband. Yes. Because you try to fight this thing. But sometimes it happens without you. It doesn't. When you wake up, you realize that the same person is. Put your hand in your skin. In Jesus' name. My sister says, give your life to Christ, huh?
Okay? Yes.
Please give your life to Christ and live this your friend. Huh?
Yes.
Which language do you speak? Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Lenny Pirella.
She knows. She knows.
Who are you? don't make me help the devil to render you to me. I'm saying Pumakwangani Mako, you say you don't know. Your husband says she knows.
2 weeks ago you said to me, my wife is seriously bad. So that's why I brought it to you.
And she says she doesn't know. And guys?
No, she knows. Just maybe she doesn't understand, but she knows. You know what she's doing.
Let me try to explain. Jesus, this is going to take long. And I thought. Woo! Yeah! Hey! Yeah! Hey! Young Tolaman. Hi, it's Freddie Mganisiabi. So your Paula, you know your weekend is zero group, you know. I was telling someone, I said, if you are not ready to be responsible, don't get married. Because you make us solve unnecessary, useless issues. If you still have a problem of sacrificing yourself as a young person for the sake of somebody else, and you have a problem of putting somebody's needs before your own needs, stay away from marriage. In fact, stay at home and be single. When you are tired of being single in your father's house, and then you get married. Because there are certain things we, especially me, there are certain conversations I'm not willing to have in my life, honestly. Do you now understand what I'm saying?
I understand, but I don't feel it at all.
I'm telling you, no bank and back. Give your life to Christ. I don't want to use the word be responsible, but be focused in your marriage.
Being relevant and being young and being beautiful.
Beauty fades, that's the truth. Ne? So let's give our life to Christ. And God will help you. Okay? Can I pray for you?
Yes.
I want to pray for you that this man must never come back to you again.
Yes.
So you can start enjoying your own husband. You stop enjoying this one. You will stay in there.
Yes.
Jesus. Let's be careful of the kind of words we use with our spouses, ne?
It's very important.
Yeah? Mama, you want to do this? That's what you need. And you must also listen to her. Okay? It's not a good thing that your parent cries about you. It's actually a curse for your parents to sit alone and wonder and start shedding tears because of you. It's a curse. Okay. Don't allow mama to shed tears. Rather, be the source of her joy. Let her think about you and smile. It's not all about that. It's not all about what you're doing. It's how you treat her and how you love her. Mama, am I right? It's about how you treat her and how you do. Look, me and my mama are very... I wish everyone can be that much close with my mom. You can never come between, even my husband knows, he can never come between me and my mother. You can't. That one is mission. You are wasting your time because it's not going to happen. Everywhere my mom goes, I'm literally the one who takes her. She doesn't go anywhere without me. Ask this one. He attempted driving my mom one day. She told us that I'm not driven by anyone except by, I don't want to die before my time. Only my daughter drives me. I'm the only one who drives her around. If not Didi or my husband, I'm the only one who drives my mother around. I am always with my mother. And it's not about what I give her. It's about the fact that I want to see her happy. You know why? She's old. And I will wake up one day, she won't be there anymore. So I'm trying to make as many memories. I'm trying to take care of her while God has given me the hands. So, no one does my mom's hair. No one does my mom's makeup. No one dresses my mom. No one drives my mom. That's my job. And if I'm not around, I pay for... You see, last week I was not around, yeah? I saved for a professional makeup artist and I paid that person. Me personally. Why? I want her when she's sitting down, when she thinks of me. If she's crying, let there be tears of joy. I am a parent of two boys. There are things that our parents do that we young people don't realize. There are prayers that our parents say in their closet. Not praying for you, even if they are not praying, but just for them sitting down and saying, my God, this child of mine, what's about? Why? What sokola sokola? You know, my child troubles themselves for my sake. God remember my child. God bless my child. Not because you are buying me presents or you are... Just because when I say I'm hungry, you cook me pap, I eat. Just because when I'm sitting down, I want a glass of water, you will run and get me a glass of water. Just when I'm sitting down, you come and ask, Mommy, what do you want? Have you eaten? Are you okay? Is there anything I can do for you? No. So please, listen to Mama. This is the one person in this life who can die for you. This person right here. This is the one person for you who can take a bullet for you. This is the one person who can go down the grave for you. This one. This is the one person who can never advise you wrongly in life. This one. This one. So please. Take care of her. Look at your mom's face. No, turn around. Look at your mom's face. Turn your boat. Look at your mom's face. Bring your hands down. Can I ask you a painful question? If your mother was to tell you, do you think your mother would die with a hidden heart about you? Why? What do you think are the last words that your mama would say to you if she would die? Do you think there'll be good words or there'll be words of, will it be a prayer or will it be a warning? Why? You must know. If you know that it will be a warning, you must know why there will be a warning. So please, let's turn that warning into a prayer of blessing. Are you hearing me? Are you ready to change? Are you sure? Start by apologizing first. I mean, like now. Like. I hope you meant your farero coming from your heart. See, you are still young, you have a bright future. Please listen to your mother. Kasi motenda mawe valide vachikuridzwa nga zvitho zvavo. Kavalide vakomorambelera patochedzo ore more navamo patochedzo. Ati? Even if friends can turn against you, if you have your mother on your back, that's all you need. In 10 years' time, 5 years' time, won't be your friend anymore. That's it? Mommy, I'm sorry. That's not how that is. This a child? So please, while you still have a chance, cut out me re in the Mubami chero. Ne? Lift up your hands, let me pray for you. Boroma, ata go mana. Ata ni mana bere mwa. Ata ni mana bere. Ata bonye mat. Jesus, yeah. Mom.
Give her a job.
Let me speak to you, no?
Yes, thanks.
Blessings are still coming. Don't forget what I said. No? God bless you.